Relations Research. In this session, we are going to discuss about the introduction to linear programming. Linear programming LP is a mathematical model used for optimizing a linear objective function subject to a set of linear inequality or equality constraints. This technique is widely applied in various fields such as economics, business, engineering and military applications to achieve the best outcome such as maximum profit or lowest cost. This is very important. In operations research, when we talk about linear programming, what we are trying to do is we are going to optimize an objective function which we label as Z, and this Z is what we try to either maximize or we try to minimize. Now, maximization is always going to be related to profit. If you are getting profit for your organization, you will obviously maximize it. And when you're talking about cost, that is the money that you need to bleed, you would always want to reduce the value. So you would say that you are trying to minimize the cost. So this is the basic objective which you can apply to various fields. Say if you are talking about an economist, when he's talking about economics of a particular country or of particular area, he would also want to do the same. He would want to maximize the profit of the country. He would want to reduce the cost that you are incurring. If you talk about business, again, the logic is going to be same. Whatever type of business you take up, it is going to be of the same criteria. When you talk about engineering and say you're talking about a plant where you have certain products to be made, so you would want to reduce the cost which is incurred in, say, the production of it. So you would want to reduce the idle time of machines, of the laborer. You would want to have more products made, but at the same time, you would want to reduce on the inventory cost. Also, you would want to reduce the transportation cost. You would want to assign the work to employees such that they have minimum idle time and they have more efficiency when they are working. So these are the plant related activities for an engineer to take care of. So this is not only related to a factory. It could be when you are working on the site, when you are doing some construction work. At that time also you want to do the same. You would want to allocate work to the laborers such that they have minimum idle time and they are utilizing the entire shift time in which they are working. You would also want to get the material to the site on time. You would want to make the finished products faster. You would not want to have more raw materials. So basically, whether you talk about a construction site or you talk about a plant where you are manufacturing a product, the basic idea is the same, of maximizing profit and minimizing the cost and various other factors apart from these two. Now, when I talk about military applications, as it is mentioned in the slide, you can see over here, I have told you in the previous session that operational research was mainly into picture during and after World War II, when the countries suffered a lot of loss because of the war. They wanted to get back their economy. Now, the best way to get back economy is when you optimize on all the aspects of the business. So, say when you're talking about the food packets being distributed, say during the World War time when there was lack of food around, or say arms and ammunition when you need to transfer from one place to another, or say there is some job given to a particular company where they're trying to, you know, grow the company after the war. So in those times, OR actually was born, and that's where it grew, and it grew to a major level. And today you would see that OR is applied everywhere. There would not be any business or any area where you would not find operation research into picture. So this is something which you need to know, and linear programming is very much useful in most of the places where you are trying to formulate your problem and get a solution to it. Key components of linear programming. The first is objective function. The objective function is a linear function that needs to be maximized or minimized. It is generally expressed in the form maximize or minimize z. This is the objective function. It is written as c1x1 plus c2x2 plus n number of terms. It depends on how many, you know, decision variables of x1, x2, x3 that you have. And this can go up to cn, xn. N will be the number of decision variables that you have to decide upon. Z is the objective function. Ci are the coefficients. They can be simple numbers like 3, 4, 5, or it could be 30, 40, it could be 500, any other number. You know, it's just numbers as coefficients. And xi are decision variables. This is the most important. You need to figure out what are the various decision variables for a particular problem, and you need to calculate its value and, if possible, optimize them such that you have maximum profit, minimum loss. So when I talk about decision variables, they are the variables that influence the outcome of the objective function. The values of these variables are what we aim to determine through the linear programming model. So basically, whatever techniques you use in linear programming, what you would want to do is find out the value of x1, x2, up to whatever x is there, xn, and you would want to substitute those values over here and find the value of z. Suppose if you are solving for a maximization problem, then known few values of x1, x2, you would want to find z at its maximum. If you are solving for a minimization type of problem, you will want to find x1, x2, x3, and you will calculate z and determine its minimum value. Next are the constraints. Constraints are the restrictions or limitations on the decision variables. These constraints can be inequalities or equalities and are expressed in linear form. So these are certain constraints given. For example, you are solving for a product, or you're solving for products A and B. Say there are few decision variables x1, x2, x3. Say for A, this will hold some value 5, 6, 7. Here it holds 4, 3, 1. And the maximum that you can produce the product A, considering these components, is say 50. And here you can produce the maximum as 60. So when you are talking about these decision variables, they will have certain constraints. You know, a product A, say it is made up of some components, x1, x2, x3, in this proportion, 5, 6, 7. So these are going to be the coefficients. So when you multiply here, this first will be 5x1 plus 6x2 plus 7x3. I have only three decision variables, and maximum value is 50. So it is less than or equal to 50. Maximum means that's the maximum you can have, not more. So if not more, the 50 is more. So that's why I have given less than or equal to sign. Similarly for the second one, if I have another constraint here, so this will be 4x1 plus 3x2 plus x3 less than or equal to 60. So you have certain equations. There could be another value also given. So accordingly, you will have certain constraints, you know. So this is how you basically write constraints. I'm not giving you a perfect problem. I'm just giving you a example as to how you form the constraint equation. A, I, J are the coefficients of the constraints. As I have written 5, 6, 7, they can be just any random number. B, I are the constants. So this is B on the right hand side of the inequalities. Inequality means it will be either less than equal to or greater than equal to, not equal to. Apart from equal to, when you write these two signs, they will be called as inequalities. The last one is non-negativity restriction. The decision variables are typically required to be non-negative. So when I talk about the decision variables that I gave you as examples, so this will be x1, x2 and x3. They are all greater than or equal to 0, which means they are non-negative. They are greater than 0 or they are equal to 0, but they are not less than 0. So they are non-negative, which means not negative. Next, we'll talk about formulating a linear programming problem. To illustrate, let's consider a simple example of a manufacturing company that produces two products. The company wants to maximize its profit. So how do you write the objective function? Just read. Suppose the profit from product 1 is $3 per unit and from product 2 is $5 per unit. The objective function can be written as 3x1 plus 5x2, and what we are trying to do is maximize because we are talking about profit of a product. Next, we'll talk about constraints. Assume the production is constrained by the availability of resources. Resource 1, 2x1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 8. And there is another constraint on the resource 2, x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 6. Non-negativity restriction is x1 and x2 will be greater than or equal to 0. So when I write it overall, I'll first write maximize Z and the equation, subject 2 and the two constraints. And lastly, I'll write the non-negativity restriction. So this is how you write it, one below the other. Next, we'll talk about solving linear programming problems. There are several methods to solve LP problems, including graphical method, suitable for problems with two variables, where the feasible region is plotted. Here, when you read, you already come to know the limitation of graphical method that you can use only two variables. So we do not prefer graphical method most of the time, because if you are having a constraint on the number of decision variables, then how will you solve? Because a company will not have always two decision variables. It will have many such decisions to make. So you cannot basically use graphical method in all the cases. Here the feasible region is plotted and the optimal solution is found visually at the vertices of this region. So I'll take up this numerical first. You will come to know with time. Say there are certain constraints that you know, or equations. So what you can do is you can just plot them, and accordingly you can decide, say this is a feasible region. So what you do is, these are the points that you talk about. At these points you calculate x1, x2. Those are the two coordinates. And then you substitute in the equation of z. Say z is 3x1 plus 5x2. So all these x1, x2 that you have found, substitute here, find the value of z. If the problem is maximization type, choose the highest value of z. If the problem is minimization type, choose the minimum value of z. So that's how you solve. Simplex method, an iterative algebraic method that starts from an initial feasible solution. When we solve, what we do is first we find the initial basic feasible solution, and then we find out the value of x1, x2, x3. Say the equation for z is 3x1 plus 4x2 plus 7x3. When I substitute these values of x1, x2, x3, I'll get some value of z. But this is a very basic solution. This is not the final solution. After this, we go for some iterative methods. We solve again and again, and we come to a point where we get an optimum value of z, and also values of x1, x2 and x3. You need to keep in mind that these values of x1, x2 and x3 will be greater than or equal to 0. They will be non-negative. If the problem is of maximization type, we will get a particular value of z. If it is minimization, then we will get another value of z based on the process of solving. Next method is interior point method. A more recent approach that approaches the optimal solution from within the feasible region rather than the boundaries. When we spoke about the graphical method, I said that you will be solving for lines such that they are giving you a feasible region. So say if this is a feasible region, I was calculating at these boundary points of this feasible region. So we were calculating at boundary. But when I talk about interior point method, it is calculating at some point which is in the interior and not on the boundary. Software tools. Many modern LP problems are solved using software tools such as MATLAB, Excel Solver, Lindo, and various specialized optimization packages. You must be aware of MATLAB, that is Mathematics Laboratory. So with the use of these equations, you can use MATLAB software and you can get the solution. Excel is something that everyone must be aware of. So here also you can solve. I will solve certain problems using these softwares and I'll give you some videos on that as well. Lindo is a software which is used for solving linear programming problems or integer programming problems, or you can say global optimization problems, non-linear problems. So it is also a type of software package. So they are all used for getting optimized solutions, and you can compare the solution by using numerical method, which is used in the lectures and with the software sessions, so that you would know if your answers are close and correct. So with this, I end the session. I hope you have understood the introduction on linear programming problems. If you have any doubt, please write to me in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon for latest video updates. See you in the next session. Thank you.